everybody, this is yours truly, Dave. I'm putting out a podcast on my YouTube channel. I'm not gonna give you the username on the YouTube channel, but I'm gonna tell you this. I will give you a better than that. I will give you someone else who needs name recognition. I've been saying all day, name recognition. They need name recognition to get their name across. Share the videos, like they keep saying, share the videos on YouTube. You can do that. Hit that like button. That's right. Hit the like button. And subscribe to my YouTube channel. You get fresh videos from me, little old me. All you have to do is hit that subscribe button on the YouTube channel. You get fresh videos from me. If it doesn't work, then don't worry about it. You'll see my videos anyway. One other thing that people have been asking on YouTube is I want to hit a 10,000K viewership. 10,000 likes. 10,000 likes, 10,000 viewership. And I want to get that YouTube button that everybody's getting. I want to hit to a million views. Million views. I want to have my videos go viral, if you know what I mean. You've seen those video viral videos on YouTube. Well, I want to make mine viral. So I want to make my videos go viral in stereo, not mono sounding. I want them to go in stereo sounding. So I'm going to do a stereo mixdown. So it sounds like a pre-recorded song. And yes, I want to iterate something for you guys. This guy needs no introduction. He goes by the name of Rogue Nation. Rogue Nation. You might have heard about him on YouTube. He's a great guy. He does First Amendment audits videos. These are with people with cameras, go audit stuff around, and go look him up on YouTube. His name, he goes by the username on YouTube about Rogue Nation. I've raised my voice. He goes by the name of Rogue Nation, just so you know. You can write that down. He goes by the name of Rogue Nation. And he's a YouTuber. He has all these videos on there, quite a few, not kidding, quite a few. And he goes out there and audits stuff. He goes audit out stuff. That's because of the First Amendment. Because you Americans have that First Amendment thing. It's your Constitution. And I'm hearing this about this HIPAA laws stuff. The HIPAA laws. They call it the HIPAA laws. Now, you might have heard about people saying this. The HIPAA law, it means, for the Americans, it means a lot of things to Americans. HIPAA law. They call it the HIPAA law. If you want to write it down, you could. The HIPAA laws are, doctors and nurses know about the HIPAA law, if you ask them that. And the First Amendment, you're allowed to record, if you're part of the media, so-called media, you're allowed to film anywhere that's public access. That's right, public access areas. If you're a newsroom, you're allowed to go in these spaces, these public spaces, and film anybody you willy-nilly. Just remember, you got to be part of the media. You got to be part of the media to do this. So First Amendment means you can film anything. They'll explain to you what that means in terms of photography. That means all access area, public area. That means sidewalks. You're allowed to film anybody, anywhere on a sidewalk. That's public sidewalks. These are public sidewalks that you people walk on. You can film from there because remember, it's a public sidewalk, not a private area. So just remember what I'm saying, folks. So go look on YouTube. He goes by the name of Rogue Nation, everybody. Give a hell yeah on that one. Rogue Nation. You might have heard about him. He was a YouTuber, and he's the best darn YouTuber ever. I kid you not. Go check him out. Really, I obliged you to do that. And he's got tons of videos, and he does these First Amendment audit videos. You might know what that means. First Amendment allows you to videotape anywhere, in public spaces, with an iPhone, a regular vlog camera, to many things. Just bear that in mind. You got the Constitution to thank for, you got the Amendments to thank for, and you got the civil rights to thank for. So there you go, folks. If you're American and you bleed red, white, and blue, you're American. And just remember, you got the amendments to deal with. Okay? The Fourth Amendment and the Fifth Amendment. And then when it comes to the amendments, you gotta know your amendments. To your Fourth Amendment, to your Fifth Amendment, to your First Amendment, to your Second Amendment. Second Amendment allows you, you can hold a gun, if you wanted to, for your Second Amendment. I'm gonna say this real loud. Second Amendment. Okay? So you Americans know about that, you should read that up. On your Second Amendments. Yeah. And vaccinations, they're talking about vaccinations. Let's say it loud and clear. Vaccinations. That's the topic that he's running by. Yeah. We're going to play it by ear. We're going to play it by ear with the vaccinations. Yes. That's what we're going to say out there. We're going to play it by ear with... Just remember, it's Premier Doug Ford. Premier Doug Ford in Ontario. He was so happy today. He was so happy today. I got to raise the glass to him. Premier Doug Ford, he's the Premier of Ontario. That's in Canada. So the Premier of Canada got his health minister there. And the task force, yes, there is a task force. I kid you not. It's not like Mike Pence, you know. We got a task force here in Ontario. They're going to head up the Pfizer and this other vaccine. They're going to do this. They're going to do it in various stages. They're already doing the health field, health nurses, health doctors, and so on and so forth, et cetera, kind of thing. Doug Ford today, Premier Doug Ford of Ontario. Yes, if you're wondering where that is, it's Ontario, Canada. Premier Doug Ford, that's the name you should worry about. He's the Premier of Ontario. So the Premier of Ontario said a little bit of things today. He was so happy about going to where the vaccines were being delivered. Remember, the Pfizer is located in the United States, not in Canada. The company's not located in Canada. It's the United States, so they got to fly it over to Canada. The company Pfizer is located in the United States, not in Canada. And the CEO of Pfizer knows that. The CEO of Pfizer knows that, of that drug company. Yeah. And that's why they're delivering it here in Canada last few days. And that's why Doug Ford was very happy about what we got our batch this week. But it's not... The general public won't get theirs until April, and I stress this strongly, April. That's the vast majority of public out there in the world. They won't get theirs until April. It's just the health people, like your nurses, your doctors, they're going to get their dose as of this week. But the general public, as they would say, the general public get theirs in April. That's the timeline they're given in April. Sometime in April, they don't know for the days, I'm going to sound like a politician here, folks. Sometime in April, the vast majority of public is going to get their vaccines. Not in droves, but with your family doctor. Remember, you don't go in and get your vaccine right away. You have to ask your family doctor if this is okay to take the vaccines. Always ask your family doctor. They'll put a commercial ad for it. Go ask your family doctor before you initiate these vaccines, okay? I'm warning you people out there. So ask your family doctor if you're a family doctor, that's great. Ask your family doctor if I can do this vaccine thing that everybody's doing. Your family doctor is your family doctor, remember that. So you just go ask your family doctor first if you could be initiated with this vaccine thing. If you do have the COVID-19 or the pandemic or whatever it is, COVID-19 thing. And they will concur to this. So I just want to iterate that. We're watching back in the background, somebody speak in the background, Ohio. and they're doing the coronavirus update. Just remember, everybody around the world is so happy. The United States has 3,000 deaths. I kid you not. 3,000 deaths. That's a large number. 3,000 deaths. That's as of the last few days. And I'm very sad. I'm very much sad. I'm not going to point that out. Very much sad of Americans. 3,000 deaths. Can you believe that? Big, large number. 3,000 deaths. It's like in the World War II, and your veterans were to be killed in the World War II, that would be how many people that were shot in the World War II. 3,000 of them. Yeah. And they were brave, they usually say they're brave soldiers. They were brave soldiers, I get that. They were brave soldiers, but they died what they did. So, that we're not talking about the war, but that's how many people who passed away due to the coronavirus. 3,000 of them, of your family members, your daughters, your uncles and mothers, and you know, the family, kind of thing. And it's a sad moment for everybody. And I mean, it's a really sad moment. They start to cry in their eyes. You can tell by their eyes from the camera angles. And it's really sad for them because they're going to cry like fiercely. So there you go. It's a very sad moment for everybody. I want to raise the glass to that. Raise the glass to that. And, yeah, so they're all going to have stories about this. It's a very sad moment. They're going to have stories about this. They were, because their family members passed away due to the coronavirus. I've heard this time and time again. And this is Americans and the Canadians have stories about this, about their family members passed away due to the coronavirus. And I want to say this in stereo sounding microphones. Yeah, we gotta do this ourselves. That's what Doug Ford says, the Premier Doug Ford of Ontario. We gotta do this ourselves, and I wanna do it like Doug Ford does it. I wanna thank my health minister. I wanna thank my task force people. I'm just delighted. I'm sounding like Doug Ford here. I wanna thank you. It couldn't be done without them. It just couldn't be done without them. I'm Doug Ford. I'm Premier of Ontario. And I have my health minister here with me. I'm delighted. I'm very much delighted for these people. I'm here every day. I'm going to sound like Doug Ford now. I'm here every day. Every day, taking your calls, taking your questions. I do Q&A. That's right. If you're asking me about Q&A, I do Q&A right after I do a speech. If you want to ask your questions, go right ahead. And that's what I'm here for. I'm Doug Ford. I'm the Premier of Ontario, and that's who I am. And I'm here for a duration, and we want to get this over with. Just like Doug Ford says, we want to get this over with. And I'll say it in English, I won't say it in French. I won't say it in the French language. So there you go. Anyway, goodbye everybody, goodbye. This is the end of the press conference. Very much, thank you very much everybody.